thank you for this wonderful presentation, for championing this work on museums. So my question for you is this possible to do as an outpatient?
I think someday, yes. This is just the beginning. You know, this is going to be perfected, it's going to get better. You know, when these go as planned, they're bored. They're sitting there just putting their thumbs. And you feel bad, you feel like you have them in prison and you don't need to be in the hospital. To do it as an outpatient though, you need to have an outpatient 24-hour facility that can see me immediately, start antibiotics, get steroids, do the cultures, get the chest X-rays, do the UA. Our center isn't set up for that. They go to the emergency room. It's an extremely busy hospital. They're going to sit there 8 hours before they even see me. So we need to do that as an inpatient. When you start something like this, yes, it's much better. Safety is important. Do it as an inpatient. But someday I can see this with an outpatient facility. And one of the keys, you know, we can grab day 9, day 10. Most people, day 9, they're out of the hospital the next day. Is moving that, making that engraftment shorter, and we have a plan to do that, where maybe, given new study pending, we're waiting approval, we could decrease that engraftment to about day 6 or 7. Certainly, if you can get the engraftment down to day 6 or 7, you're again thinking outpatient. But good question, I think that would cut the cost even more. I wouldn't do it yet, though.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Will there be a campaign or a drive to drive the facts to the neurologists, you know, to provide the solid evidence that definitely this is a far better option for these patients on the most appropriate condition? Because, based on my experience, there are still few neurologists who need convincing, that's the patients who are very confused. Thank you.
Yeah, no, I've never had to convince anybody along the way. of course, neurologists are conservative. They're conservative by training. I found, and that's completely okay. I found the younger ones to be much more open to this, and the ones who have seen our patients are convinced, actually. The neurologists I work with are actually more likely to say they want the patient to get the transplant than me. You know, when we're looking at early secondary progressive, I'm saying no, and I've sometimes been talked into it by the neurologists because, you know, they've become very much proactive in recognizing the value of this therapy. So it's getting a neurologist at your own center, you're probably a younger neurologist, and having them actually see these patients, and you can get real confidence that actually end up being more aggressive when you talk this therapy than even you as a hematologist or I myself, which has been one of the surprises as I've developed this field. But yes, medicine as a whole is a conservative profession, and we have to prove ourselves along the way, and in reality, it shouldn't be any other way. Thank you.
Thank you, Richard Burt.